Beta class mono, principal John, order Alice Tanumi's Devin Hydro Karate TA and Jesus Halakula. And we have three species here in Hawaii, Halakula Hawaiiana and Halakula Discipiens. You can see both of them right there on the side. And the way you can tell them apart is that Halakula Hawaiiana has kind of more of like a smooth outer edge to the leaves, while Halakula Discipiens has kind of like a more serrated edge when they're more like wide at the base, whereas Hawaiiana is like kind of slimmer. So that's kind of how you can decipher the two. And this is just a figure that I put on here, kind of characterizing the grass. It has thin leaves, rhizomes, and then it also has many small seeds that the male produces that is carried in the water column. Yeah, so the life history is similar to land plants, specifically flowering plants. The male has, like I said, non-motile seeds, which are carried in the water column and hopefully get into the female gamete, so they can be fertilized. And then this is the scientific paper that I looked at, and the purpose of this was to compare the feeding behavior of the native snails on the native seagrasses, which is the Hawaiiana species, and the invasive seagrass, which is the Discipiens species. So what they basically did in this experiment was that they placed four transects in the Kahala Mandarin Lagoon area, and they basically surveyed both of the species and kind of compared the population size, growth pattern, amount of grazing from the native snail, and the leaf shape. They also did similar research in Alamoana Beach Park in Kaneohe Bay, but I'm just gonna focus on the Kahala area. So this is the snail that I was talking about, the native snail, Smaragdia bryanae, and it prefers to feed on the Halakula Hawaiiana rather than the Halakula Discipiens. So that's why there's not a lot of Hawaiiana in the lagoon area. Oh, sorry, I don't know why that happened. That did not look like that earlier. But, okay. So, I guess you can't really see the black one, but it was white earlier. And this is a box right there. That's like the Kahala area where they did the study. And I'm really sorry that it's blocking the other one, but that's basically just a map of the Kahala area where they were surveying the two species. And basically what they found was that Halakula Hawaiiana was only found in like the east corner of the lagoon, and then the whole rest of the lagoon was good with the invasive species. Okay, so on the left side you can see the transects A, B, C, and D. That's where they were surveying the species. And then the one on the right is the basically the data they collected from the transects, and it basically shows that you can't really see the difference of it, but there was a lot more Halakula Discipiens than Halakula Hawaiiana on all four transects. And then this is just the GPS data that they collected from the experiment. The red dots you see are the patches of Halakula Discipiens that they recorded with the GPS. And they concluded from this experiment that Halakula Hawaiiana is very important for the benthic community and the native sea snail, since that's its food, basically. And then the Halakula Discipiens, alien seagrass, is dominating this habitat, and it's really important that we, I guess, try not to let it do that, since if we get rid of the native species of seagrass, then it'll basically wipe out the, it'll basically make the native snail extinct, since it doesn't have any food. And then these are my references. Yeah. Any questions?